Good morning, everybody. So, I'm excited to come on this morning. We're going to talk a little bit about working with our ancestors and working with spirit guides. So I'm going to give people just a few minutes to kind of hop on. I'm going to get my sage and smudge going. And then I'm feeling called to work with this particular stone that I introduced in one of my sessions last, maybe the beginning of this week or last week, something like that. So I recently wrote a blog post that I talked about working with stones specifically. I did the introduction of working with stones and crystals, so sort of the difference, right? You have, this is a crystal, this is a piece of quartz, and we talked about how quartz can be programmed, which is this, and you can set it up basically like programming a computer, okay? So you can set the intention with a crystal like this, with a quartz crystal. But I'm just using that as an example. But the stone that I'm feeling called to work with is this one. So this one has a bit of... Basically, its name to me, I believe, is something along the lines. It's an association with stars and ancestors. So this is like my ancestor stone is what I'm hearing. And anyway, so I'm still learning about this stone. I'm not super familiar with it because it is new to me. But anyways, so I'm going to be using this particular stone during our time today. So what we're going to be focusing on, it's from a question that someone asked me last week, and it's about how to work with our ancestors. So how to work with our ancestors and how to work with spirit guides. If we aren't already, if we don't already have an active relationship with them, how do we become aware of the spirit guides and ancestors that are working with us? Because they are already in some kind of way. So how do we become aware of who we're working with? And how do we develop that relationship? What does that look like? So we're going to do a meditation today, and we're going to talk a little bit about how to initiate that relationship. And if for some reason you don't feel called to work with your ancestors or spirit guides, that's fine. You don't have to go into the meditation, or if you do, just be sure that you don't set that intention, because that's always the key. It's about setting the intention and making the request for the relationship, or for more insight into the relationship, or to deepen the relationship. So, before we go into the meditation, I'm going to share just a little bit about my own path of working with my ancestors and with spirit guides. So there's a whole story for me around this. I'm not going to tell you the name of my spirit guide. There's certain things that, like, in your personal practice that you sometimes are going to put it out there and sometimes you're not. And there's like quite a bit about the guides that I work with that I don't like speak out into the material world. So it is very private, and I highly recommend that you sort of sit with that. So I have people that I process with about my guides and ancestors and that sort of thing. Good morning, everybody. So Yeah, I will like share those details, but I'm not going to get into those details here because this is a pretty broad, like so many people are going to see this. And so it really gives a lot of insight and gives a lot of access for people to me if I name my guides and my ancestors that I'm working with. So I'm going to talk about them, but I'm not going to name them. Okay? So that's something. So again, we're talking about how to work with our ancestors and our spirit guides. Part of the question that came through, and I'm really grateful to the person that asked that question because I think it's a really good one, is how to initiate that relationship, how to know who to work with, because not everyone in our, bloodline or our lineage or our ancestry is someone that we want to bring forward and like have active in our energy field, right? Like we all have, I'm sure, known or unknown to us, those that we are not interested in connecting with and developing that relationship with. So, and that's fine. It always comes down to setting the intention first and foremost of, finding out sort of like your intention, what is calling you to work with your spirit guides? Like, why is that showing up on the surface for you? So getting clear yourself about that first and foremost is really super important. Why do I want to work with my ancestors? Why do I want to work with spirit guides? For me, it's because I've had a call to that for a very long time, and I've been working with them unbeknownst to me since I was a child. So it was learning how to develop that relationship in such a way that I could actually learn from it and navigate it. And so much of it has to do with the work that I do in the world. And so following this path of doing, healing facilitation, following the shamanic path, all of those things have been calling me to working with spirit guides and ancestors for years and years and years. So for me, it was just a natural thing. So again, I would say, what is it that's inspiring you? What's showing up on the surface right now? That's sort of asking for your attention as far as developing that relationship. Okay. So first and foremost is getting clear on your intent. Second is asking for that relationship, that rapport to deepen. So it's already there. We already have energies that we're working with that we may or may not even be, aware of. So, those of us who are developing the skills of actively cultivating that relationship, the most important thing is, once again, return to our intent to say, like, I want to develop that relationship, and this is why. And so you're putting that out there, right? And we're going to do a meditation in just a minute to work on this. The other thing is making sure that within your intent, you have healthy boundaries. So I never just open myself up to like, I'm open and receptive to any energies that would know. Like I'm not even gonna like complete that statement. Like I'm absolutely not open to just any energies that want to work with me. Like hell no. So that opens you up for a whole lot of stuff that you don't need, you don't want, whatever. So what you want to do is be really clear, again, returning to your intent is I want to work with ancestor energies and spirit guides who are helping me for my highest good. So I always return to sort of the Reiki principles around this. So for me, because I'm, a Reiki practitioner and a Reiki teacher master, everything that I do is always going to be seeped in those Reiki principles of the fact that first of all, it can never be done wrong, so I can't mess up, and that it's always going to be for my highest good. So everything I do in my practice and the healing work that I do and the shamanic path that I walk is always protected in that energy and that intent that it's always for my very highest good. Okay? So for those of you who are hopping on, if you have questions along the way, please ask them. I'll keep an eye out and be sure to answer any questions that come through to the best of my ability with the time that we have. And if I don't get to them today, then I'll circle back. And I'm hearing that I'm probably going to write, my next blog post is going to be on this subject. So, okay, so intent is super important. The other thing, so always being sure that the intention is around calling in ancestors and spirit guides who are only interested in working with you for your highest good. Okay, that's going to weed out any energies, any ancestors, any whatever in the spirit world that you don't want to call into your life that isn't going to be of service. Okay, so that's really important. So healthy boundaries in our life, no matter what realm we're working in, whether it's in the material realm and developing relationships here, or if it's in the spirit realm and developing relationships in that arena, you have to be clear. And you don't want to be over porous, because that's just not good energetic hygiene. Okay. Okay. So that sort of sets the tone. We're going to go through a quick meditation. I'm going to take you into the cave of the spiritual heart, and I'm going to guide you through a few questions. The most important thing is to be receptive and open to what comes forward. So you may experience all kinds, like everyone is very different in how they receive the communication from the spirit realm. Some people see things, some people know things, some people hear things, some people feel things. Okay, so depending on what your primary spiritual gifts are, which you may not be aware of, right? You maybe haven't pinpointed that yet through your personal practice. So don't worry about figuring that out, because through doing meditations like this is when you're going to notice like what your primary gifts are. So just pay attention to how things come through and be receptive to them. So notice any, the mind likes to be very logical and try to tell you that you're making things up. I promise you that you're not, and the more that you can open yourself up to those subtle communications and insights that are coming through and allow that flow, the more information you're going to get, the deeper the rapport is going to be. But that is a natural part of developing our practice of cultivating those psycho-spiritual gifts of like being receptive to our intuition and how that communication comes through. So that's really important. Just watch the mind and just be open and receive everything, kind of like you're a kid. You know, invite your inner child to do this, because your inner child is like excited about anything that shows up and is willing to entertain, you know, the imagination, and that's what's required. You need to be willing to be open to your imagination here, okay? Because that's where those communications come through. Okay, so let's begin the meditation. So again, I have my ancestor stone that I'm working with because it asked me to work with it. So I have that with me. So if there's any stone or anything that you're feeling called to as I'm talking about this, just grab it and have it be with you. You know, you may not know why, it doesn't matter. You don't need to know why. Just trust, you know, that's the most important thing. We don't always have to know the answers. We don't always have to figure it out, even though oftentimes we want to. So, all right, let's find a comfortable seat and close the eyes. Connect to the breath. First and foremost, you want to see, sense, feel, hear, and know that your grounding cord is connected. So I want you to begin by seeing a ethereal flow or cord of light from the elevated aspect of the stars, sun, moon, the universe, flowing down through the crown of the head, down through the space between the eyebrows, throat, heart, belly, base of spine, all the way down into the center of the earth. So grounding down into the earth. And then inhale from the center of the earth, back up through the root, low belly, and into the heart. Bring the awareness into the heart center. Take a few breaths here. See yourself encapsulated in a protective bubble of white light. This is your filter, your energetic filter, your protection. This is that bubble of light that holds the intention that the only energies that we are calling in and on are those that have our highest good in their intentions. So only energies, only ancestors and spirit guides who are here to work with us for our highest good are allowed into this space with us. Really important. So then as we bring our awareness into the heart, I want you to imagine that you're resting in the cave of your heart and sitting before your sacred fire. This is the eternal flame that resides within all of us. This is a place of communion. In some lineages or some traditions, this is called the inward direction, the seventh direction. So as you sit before the flame, the sacred flame, within the cave of your heart, take a moment to notice what the cave of your heart looks like. How does it feel? What does the ground beneath you feel like, look like? What is the cave made of? Is it an actual cave, or is it more of like a wickiup made of saplings or trees? Is it an open space in the forest, right? So just take notice of what the cave of your heart looks like, what it feels like. So this is a space that you can come back to anytime you want. So again, returning back to setting that intention that we're only calling forward energies that are working for our highest good and well-being. This is going to filter out all the other energies. At this point, I would have you ask the question, what ancestors or spirit guides are currently working with me right now? Reveal yourself in a way that I can know you. So this might offer you up the opportunity to feel them, to see them, to sense them, to hear them, to know them. Then perhaps asking, or first, introducing yourself. So they already know who you are, but it's just a good practice. It's polite to introduce yourself. So some of you have spirit names, names that you have received from spirit. So many of you already know one of mine, which is Surya Om, because I use it on my Instagram, and I've carried that name for many, many years. So when I'm traversing in the spirit realm, I often am identifying myself by my spirit name, or one of them. I have several, actually, and it all depends on the work that I'm doing, which one I'm going to use. So if that isn't part of your practice at this time, you just introduce yourself as you know yourself now. with your given name, your birth name. Although it might be interesting because you might receive your spirit name just by me bringing this up to you. So you might have just received your name. So if you did, I'd be really interested to hear about that. You should message me privately. So introduce yourself. And if you have any questions specifically that you would like some insight on or help with, then ask them about themselves. So it's like going on a date, right? Like you don't just want to talk about yourself because that's kind of boring, right? So you want to ask them questions. Who are you? Where do you come from? What information do you have for me today? How can I develop a relationship with you? And just be receptive, be open. So many of you who are carrying really strong gifts, my photographers out there, my horticulturists and herbalists, plant medicine people, artists, craftsmen, all of you that carry specializations, those of you who are teachers, so I'm pretty much talking about everybody, right? You may find that many of these gifts, talents, and abilities that you carry come from your ancestral line. So those of you who are photographers, this is a way of developing vision. You're able to see things that others don't, and you see them in a very specific way. And that specific way helps people to open themselves up to aspects of themselves, to see things, to feel things, to know things. So in any case, I bring that up because your ancestor or spirit guide may be sharing information with you about those specialized gifts. I certainly have. My spirit guide is custom made for developing my shamanic abilities, my all of the skills that I carry, most of them have come from teachings and offerings from my ancestor guide. I think the other thing that's really interesting is people feel my ancestor guide very strongly. So people often will feel your ancestry, the energies that you're working with as a part of who you are. And then more you get to know these energies that are working with you and on your behalf, the more certain qualities that you carry will make sense to you. Just going to give you a moment to kind of commune here. So I'm hearing if you have a specific tool that you're working with in your practice, maybe a crystal, a stone, a plant, perhaps you have been feeling that call like I have to be a drum carrier, or you work with another type of instrument, you could ask about that. They have insight for you around that. Why you carry that particular instrument, why you feel called to that particular skill set, whatever it is. Questions are always the key because we have free will, and ancestors and spirit guides that are working with us for our highest good will never overstep our boundaries. They'll never do anything without permission. So that's very important to understand. So you must ask the questions and must make yourself receptive. And that's when the information flows. Good. So we'll just take another breath or two here. So whatever information has come forward, whatever has been revealed, whatever it is that you've come to know from this meditation, if anything, offer gratitude for it. And I'm hearing to remind you that if you have heard that it's not time for you to work with a spirit guide or ancestor, that's okay too. Trust, because there are reasons for everything. So being obedient and trusting what you're receiving is super important. Everything, honestly, in this way is an initiation. And so the way that we respond to the internal promptings that we receive and how we embrace them, honor them, and respect them is extremely important. Good. So we'll offer up gratitude and appreciation to all of our guides, our ancestors who have come forward. Thank you to the cave of our heart and the eternal flame for the sacred space, the protective bubble of light, our grounding cord that keeps us safely connected to the material world. And then begin to follow your breath back to the physical body. Start to move the fingers, stretch, breathe. And when you're ready, open the eyes. Coming back. Okay, cool. So thank you all so much. Please reach out to me if you have questions, anything came up for you that you would like to process. I would love to talk to you. I continue to do all of my sessions by donation right now. I'm also open to questions, so a lot of the things that I'm talking about in these sessions are answering questions that people have shared with me. So I want to thank you all for your support. I will continue to put my Venmo and PayPal information in the description of the video. But if there's any questions that you have, don't hesitate to reach out. I hope you all have a beautiful day, and I will connect with you again on Friday at the same time, 8:30. All right, thank you all. Bye-bye.